Welcome to the second part of the news and enhancements of the ROT2 version 33. If we compare the toolbar results from the version 32.1 and the new version 33.0, we can see that again a certain number of icons have disappeared, and these are all the icons in the result function for the sectional results, the support, the nozzle loads, deformation breaks, and the additional results. All these have now been removed to the new list functions. And the list function is very powerful, actually. It also includes the full set of input data that was available previous under the properties window. In the properties window, you could see the components like bends, flanges, valves, reducers, tees, and so on. Also all the different supports, different couplings, inner supports, hinges, masses. All this data is now all concentrated under the new list function in one symbol. Now the list function therefore is quite powerful and needs two layers of selection. The first one is here in yellow, and here you can choose between the nodes, the components, the supports, the couplings, the masses, text, and the results. And for each of them you have in the green bar here the next level of selection. For example, for the results you would have the sectional results, the support loads, deformation breaks, additional results, and so on, and flange loads, and so on and so on. In the list function you can directly edit the data, yeah, either from a single column, a single value, or you can select different lines and modify them all in the same way by, for example, selecting directly the header of the corresponding column. Instead of going through the text, I would like to show you it to you directly on the ROT2 graphical user interface. So here's my ROT2 model, and you can see that on the properties list data you have the access to the list, and you also have it here in the listing icon. First of all, you can see this first layer here with the nodes and segments, the components, the supports, the couplings. And as you know from the previous versions of ROT2, whenever you have the column titles here on the left, you can select which columns you want to show. If you're only interested in the component type and x, y, z coordinates, you can just bring up these columns. Now you also know that if you select something in here, it will show up in the color coding in the graphic. So for example, you can select this part and you can see which numbers are concerned. On the other hand, you can also go in the graphic, select part, and hide, for example, the rest. So segments show only the selected segments, and directly you would see that the nodes that are displayed are only from the segments that are visible and not the ones from the hidden part. And if I bring it back up and show all segments again, it will show up all of them. All these tables, you can select some lines in here and you can save the data directly to the disk. For example, here I would say this would be nodes, and write it as a CSV file. And now I can look at the folder in which the document is stored, and I can find my node.csv file, which I can just double click to open it, and here are my nodes. So there's the complete transparency to the data to use them for other functionality, and this is available for the input data and also for the output data. So in the input data, the node data, the segment data, then of course we have all the different the bends, the reducers, the valves, the flanges, the tees, all the components. And for these again, if you click on a certain line, it will show up where it is. So let's go through some other elements. Here under the supports you find all the rigid supports with their names, their functionality, and all the parameters like friction. You have the spring hangers. If the spring hangers have some names, you'll find them here. Then we have the coupling, the spring coupling that we have specified here. We can find the spring rate here. We have no point masses, but we have some texts. For example, we have the text from the component description. So let's bring them up here using the display parameter function and show the text. And now you can see the different entries here. And for example, if you want to show the text for the valves to show up from all the different text. You can just select them and change the color here and say, okay, they should come up in green. And so now you see that these are now in green. You could also change the size, for example, for this one and say, I want to have it in 2 times bigger. Let me show you some other nice feature. You have down here a small slider, and with this slider you can influence the size of the different elements. For example, if you choose text here, you can zoom in and out and make it bigger and smaller. So let's undo this and go have a look at some of the results. So I will go to the load case here, primary loads. I see my deformation. I can bring up my list function, and now I'm zoomed into the results. So this would be the result part, and the sublevel will show sectional results, general support loads, the support loads, hanger results, deformation breaks, and if I have flange loads, I can also check the flange loads, for example here with a rating of the equivalent pressure to the nominal pressure of the flange. All these data can again be saved and processed later on, and most of them are also accessible directly in the report template. If I had an expansion joint analysis, I would also find the results here. For the valves, I can have the list of the valve loads. If there is any flange analysis that was performed, it will also be shown here. If I have finite element substructures included, they will be also shown here. All this data again available for the documentation. If I go to a stress analysis result here, I can see the stress utilizations directly. And if I have overstress, I get a red warning, and I can directly select the nodes where these are, and with a double click zoom in on the part that is concerned here, and check the stresses maybe directly on the node to see the detailed results. So let's go back to the presentation for a second. We have seen the zoom function quickly already. You can now zoom in on the texts, but you can also zoom in on the node names, the segment text, the dimensioning, the support symbols. So whatever the size of your model is, you can always find the correct size for the texts. So now I've brought up many different graphical elements here, isometrics, texts, the node symbols, and so on. And now I can choose which one I want to scale here at the same time. If I select them all, and then scale it, all texts and graphic elements are scaled at the same time. So you can see that the text is bigger. Also, the support symbols here are increased in size. But you could also say I only want to scale some elements, for example, only the dimensioning, and keep all the other elements in the same size. And then the zoom will only act on the dimensioning texts, for example. And so you can independently choose the right size for each element. So while we're discussing the different options how to display the graphics, then now is a new feature that you can include the north arrow using the project setting graphic option here, show north arrow, and you can give the direction of the north on the isometric, or you can change it based on the coordinate system. For example, if it's in the other way around here. And of course, if you go to the print preview, you could also see the north arrow on the printed sheet. Another nice feature is the tooltip control. When you hover over some components in row 2, you can see that there is a tooltip that shows up, and you can now configure the setting of the tooltip. There is a property window in which you can select which information should be shown when you hover over which part. So for example, if I hover over a node, I get the information about the node and the component. If I hover over a segment, I get segment information like pipeline name, material ID, dimension, or line mass. I can use the setting of this property window to modify this, and you can see all the different components that you can change. For example, here in the segment, I could remove the line mass information and add, for example, insulation density, insulation thickness here. Press OK, and now when I hover over a segment, I will see the insulation density shown, and the other components are still the same. Okay, I will stop here for today. Thanks for watching, and hope you tune in next time.